It's your voice, your vote. We're continuing our conversations this morning with your candidates as we get closer to Election Day in August. Earlier this week, we spoke with Dale Lane and Floyd Bonner, who are running for Shelby County Sheriff.
Now, David Lenoir joins us here in the studio. He served as county trustee since 2010 and is now running for Shelby County Mayor. David Lenoir, welcome back to Live and I. Glad to have you here.
Yeah, good morning. Glad to be here. Thank you.
One of the major issues as county mayor you would have to deal with if elected would be the budget and budget requests coming from Shelby County schools. And from what we're hearing, there could be a potential, $12 million gap, they're saying. Right. How would education be viewed by David Lenoir?
Well, education would be at the forefront of really my campaign and my administration. Alex, it's so important. I mean, we spend $400 million out of a $1.2 billion budget on education. Many feel that they're not getting a good return on their investment. And so actually one of the things that I proposed is in the mayor's administration is to have what I've called an education liaison. I'm a reader, and Jim Collins' book, Good to Great, he said, good is the enemy of great. Mm-hmm. And so what we want to do here in Shelby County is create a great education system here in Shelby County. And so that education liaison would be tasked with the force, with the responsibility of creating a great education system here in Shelby County. Whether it's a curriculum, whether it's a pre-K, whether it's our technical college and the connectivity between our private sector and MoreTech, Southwest, CBU, Lemoyne Owen, University of Memphis, Rhodes.
What would this liaison exactly do that would make it different than what we have now?
Well, one, it's a new position. There's no one in the mayor's administration right now who is tasked with that responsibility of creating a great education system. So one thing that the mayor does is it has a pulpit and a platform to go out and talk in the community about the needs of education. So one, I think it's the ability to pull policymakers, superintendents together. I've talked to several superintendents about the idea. They like the idea. But also hold our school systems accountable.
So keep it on the forefront, really.
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, and would you also push for, again, this year we've seen the city of Memphis get more so involved with education and funding.
Sure. But there's still some tension.
Exactly. Would you push for the city to also say, do your part even more so?
You know, I would. I mean, I'm fortunate to have a great relationship with Mayor Strickland. We worked on blight initiatives and poverty initiatives as the banker for Shelby County. I mean, I appreciate the fact that the city stepped up and helped with the pre-K funding. But I think it's really a question of accountability. I mean, I'm sure it'll come up in the course of the campaign. Are we funding education enough? And I think as we answer that question, we've got to think about how the school systems are spending the existing monies that they have.
Okay, let's talk about opioid abuse. It's
okay.
been a huge issue
it
and
is.
A lot of tension between the county commission and the current mayor. What would you do to stem that? What needs to be done differently?
Well, first of all, we need to reduce the tension between the mayor and the county commission and all acknowledge that we're in the same boat in terms of addressing the opioid crisis. I had breakfast yesterday with a gentleman whose son unfortunately died of an overdose. So it's very real. It's very personal. I think Dr. Haushalter in the mayor's administration, the director of public health, has done a great job of outlining a plan that relates to prevention, acknowledgement, intervention, but also things that need to maybe happen legislatively or in our judicial system as far as court proceedings and lawsuits.
Going after the dealers?
To hold them accountable.
All right. Let's also talk about crime these days. A lot of folks perceive crime in Shelby County as a Memphis problem, not necessarily a Shelby County problem. How would you address crime from the standpoint
the reality
of working with the sheriff?
Yeah, Alex, I mean, crime is a Shelby County problem. I mean, when your city of Memphis is two-thirds of your population, and the reality is crime exists all throughout Shelby County, whether it's Collierville, Millington, Arlington, any of the suburbs. But first of all, we do have to acknowledge that crime is a Shelby County problem. It impacts economic development. If our law enforcement experts tell us that we need more sheriff, more police, I'm going to lean on our sheriff and our police directors to say we need more boots on the ground. But I don't believe we can build enough jails or hire enough police to address the crime that exists within the community. Again, I'm a reader. An author of a book that I read several years ago said the most dangerous person in the world is a person with no hope. Mm-hmm. And I think we have to build a great education system, but also coupled with that is great economic or great job opportunities have to exist within our community. It really has to be a two-generation approach. Mm-hmm. We have to make the investment in education, particularly early childhood education. Mm-hmm. The ability for a child to read often is a predictor of their of their future path. But at the same time, if that job opportunity does not exist when he or she graduates, and that's why we need this two-generation approach of great education and great jobs.
Before we run out of time, disparity studies in Memphis and Shelby County show still there are a lot of issues there for women and minorities getting involved and getting their fair share. What would you recommend there to make sure the platform is as level as possible?
Well, one, Alex, I would say, yes, it's something that we need to focus on. I think anybody that looks at my background, the 8 years I've served as the trustee, we began a relationship with Tri-State Bank. We started, we made deposits of taxpayer dollars with Tri-State Bank. I told a group this weekend, Shelby County is financially stronger today than it was 8 years ago after the recession and due to the good leadership of Mayor Luttrell. We need to make sure that Shelby County is strong for everyone in Shelby County. Okay. Whether you're in Collierville, Klondike, Smoky City, North Haven, Whitehaven, any part of this great county that we live in.
All right. David Lenoir, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Appreciate you being here with us this morning.
Glad to. Thank you.